Any more or less complex application requires state management. In this video, I start to look at using NGXS state management library with Angular. I won't rehash the NGXS manual. It's actually pretty good. I'll show my vision of using states and some examples of practical implementation as part of my front architecture. Each component has a state, which in a simple case are the properties of an instance of the components class, the result of method or something provided by component dependencies, such as a stream of values from a service, can also be part of the state. The snapshot of these values at a certain point in time can be represented as an object. And this object itself is the state of the component and completely determines what the component's view looks like at a given point in time. This object is just an idea and doesn't exist in real life. But I think you agree that it would be very convenient to implement something like this and store a state-related data in one place. And this NGXS comes into play. It allows you to centralize state data and logic into a separate class. Now the representation of the view will depend on the state class. This class represents the state of the task view component. The component itself is quite simple. It has three modes: create, edit, and view. One title input field, draw with menu options, apply and cancel buttons. This interface is a state model. Essentially, a state model is an implementation of this object from the diagram we looked at earlier. It represents all the data at the current moment in time that determines what the component's view looks like. The two main big blocks of the state class are selectors and actions. I'll talk about both in detail in the next video. For now, I'm just saying that we use selectors to retrieve state data where we need it, and we use actions to change the state. To put it very simply, selectors can be thought of as state output and actions as state input. In theory, every component can have state. For example, a simple button may be enabled, disabled, or in a progress state after being clicked. But I usually only create state classes for routing components, such as the task screen shown above and other screens. Also for components that are supposed to be reusable and require persistence of state throughout the application. In some cases, we will need to decompose a complex state. For example, a large component with image editing tools. The panel with various effects and filters has a complex state, but it's used only as a part of the parent component. So, do I need to create a separate state for this? To make a decision, I ask myself, is it possible that I want to reset the panel state separately from the parent component state? And if the answer is yes, this is a hint to create a separate state class. In addition to states associated with specific components, we have states that store context that is important to the application as a whole. We can call them application level states, for example, user state and task state. Let's look at the state of the tasks. The model is very simple, it's just an array of task objects. We use selectors to access task objects throughout the project. And with actions, we can add, remove, and update tasks in state. User state is another application level state. The state model contains the user object, authorization status, and integrations list. Selectors allow you to retrieve user data and statuses. And with the help of actions, we can change the user state. You may also notice that action handlers not only update state, but also use services. This is because I use states to centralize all the logic. This video is just the first part of a conversation about NGXS. In the next one, I'll talk about selectors and actions. So don't forget to subscribe, like, and share your opinion in the comments. Thank you.